what I am going through. Even though Elisha prophesied that there is going to be an abundance of rain, but he looks at the environment and what is going on, and he found out that what he is going through will not be able, what he is seeing will not be able to produce the rain that he called for. So he went to the mountain Carmel and began to pray. Hallelujah. He went to the mountain Carmel and he began to pray. And the Bible said that the disciples also at that time, they themselves, they were frustrated and didn't know what to do, and they begin to argue among each other. Hallelujah. Most of the time when it comes to our homes, most of the times we begin to argue with our wives. Most of the time we begin to argue with our friends. Most of the time we begin to argue with ourselves. And we ask ourselves, is this thing going to be possible? It is not going to be well. We cannot make it because of the failures that we made in the past. We feel like we cannot make it because of some problems that we encounter in the past. We feel like that because of that problem, we will not be able to make it because of the weather experience that Elisha had went through. Every time that weather becomes like that, it is not able to rain. But even though he has prophesied that it is going to rain, those of us that have lived in Africa, you know there are some of us that can look into the skies. We don't have anything like meteorologists that will come on the television and proclaim that there is the sound of the abundance of rain. But we just look into the skies and look at how the clouds is moving now, and we say tomorrow it is going to rain now, and we say 3 o'clock it is going to rain now. We just look at the movement of the clouds and we say it is going to rain now. Elisha looked at the movement of the clouds and saw that there is no sound of the abundance of rain now, even though he has prophesied there is going to be abundance of rain now. So he has to go back and pray. Sometimes we look at the cloud, we do not look at how God is moving, but we look at how the crowd, the people around us, they are moving in life. And we look at how speed those that are ahead of us are moving now, and we tend to get intimidated. Are we going to be able to make it? Even I that is smarter, even I that is this person that is very smart, that is why he has been able to make it. And I am not smart like this person now, so I will not be able to make it. I am not eloquent like this person now, I don't flow in speaking English like this person now, so I will not be able to make it. This person has been able to make it because he has good qualifications in education. Now, and I do not want good qualifications. And the job is saying that you get to get this qualification now before you can get the job. You look at these situations and this environment. You look at your financial situations and what you are going through, and it feels like it is not going to be possible. The same people in your life that you are working with, the same people in your life that you are assisting in life, the same people text against you, and you feel like it is not going to be well. You are not going to make it in life. Your vision is coming down. I have a good news for you, that we have a living God. Hallelujah. The Bible said that they saw Jesus and they said that it is a ghost. When you look at the definition of a ghost, a ghost is something that is dead or the appearance of a dead person. Hallelujah. A ghost is something that is dead, that is believed to what? Appear or reappear to people. That is a ghost. You know, something that is dead. Hallelujah. Something that is dead, that is trying to reveal itself, or that believe to reveal itself again. Hallelujah. But I came to tell you, somebody, that the situation that is frightening you, the situation that is coming that is frightening you, that you are afraid of, it is already dead because it is appearing as a ghost. It looks like a ghost, but it is not a ghost. It is already dead. That situation that you feel like it is not going to be possible, that situation that you feel like that is making you feel like there is no God, that situation that is making you feel like the power of God, doubt the power of God upon your life, that situation that makes you feel like that you cannot complete your assignment that God has given you, I come to declare unto somebody that situation is already dead. You are walling yourself about something that is already dead. You are already frustrated about something that is already dead. You are already thinking about something that is already dead. You are spending times and hours meditating on something that is already dead, something that looks like a ghost, something that is dead, and you are troubled with it, and you don't know what to do. But I come to declare unto you, there is no power in that which is confronting you, that is making you feel like you cannot make it in life, because that situation is already dead. God has already taken care of it on the cross. He died on the cross and said it is finished. I come to declare unto you, somebody, that the pain that you are going through, God has already provided a cure to that pain that you are going through. The financial financial struggles that you are going through, I came to declare unto you that God has already provided for us. For he said in his word, silver and gold belongs to him. I came to declare unto you that the struggles that you are going through in life, God has already provided the answer. But you are not just believing it. You are not just seeing it. You are not looking unto that. You are not seeing from the perspective of God. You are seeing from the move of God, from all man. You are seeing it based on your environment. Hallelujah. Amen. Were people that were very close to God. Hallelujah. Amen. Elisha was somebody who was very close to God. The disciples were people that were very close to Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. Yet still, when the situations of life, when the realities of life begin to hit them, hallelujah, they begin to question, how possible will they be able to overcome these things? But they forgot that they have a living God. A God who has power over all things. Hallelujah. And I came to declare unto you, somebody, that God has already taken care of that bills that you are crying for, or that pills that you spent night not sleeping and thinking about it, premeditating about it. Oh, how do I pay my bills? God has already taken care of it. Hallelujah. He said in his word that he has paid all our debts. Hallelujah. He has already taken care of that bill. But it is left for you to believe. Hallelujah. When they were arguing that it is him, and some of them were saying that it is not him, Jesus opened his mouth and said, fear not, for it is me. You are thinking that it is a boost. It is coming to threaten you. It is going to kill you. It is going to frustrate you. But you know, I came to tell you, somebody, today, that which you are saying, thinking that it is a boost, it is not a boost. That which you are thinking that it is going to kill you, it is that which the Lord is going to use it to save you. They were thinking that it is a boost, but not knowing it was the Savior of the world that was working towards them. Now, sometimes we feel like what we are going through is going to kill us. The job that we are not going to, we are not getting is killing us, is killing us slowly. But I want you to know that God is using to save you. For all things work together for good, for those that love the Lord. I know most of you have given up upon the church. Some of you have given up upon the church. And they are like, oh, when will these things be? When is the church even going to grow? Some of you were expecting that, oh, when we join the church, there is going to be thousands of people, because pastor has insight and vision to see ahead. So he's going to prophesy. And when people come, they are not going to leave. You were expecting that the prophecy will bring a good result. But when they came and their expectation were not being met, they said, oh, we are investing in the wrong thing. We have to move. They said, oh, we are not investing in the right thing. So we get to get out of the church. But I kept to declare unto you, it is not about me, and it is not about you. It is about the Almighty God. He is God, and he showed favor to whom favor is due. He has a plan, and he has a will. And not until the plan of God is revealed. And when you think like man, you will always be frustrated. If you think like, how am I going to make it? How is the church going to make it? And you look at the physical appearance and our resources, and you look at what we have and what our resources and the people in it, you are going to be deceived. But I came to declare unto you, do not be deceived, for the Lord is on our side. If God be for us, who can be against us? I don't care if the kind of finances that we have. I don't care the kind of people that will stand against us. I don't care the kind of people that will fight against us. All I know is that I have a God by my side, and we have a God by our side. And if God be for us, nobody can be against us. I came to declare unto you, somebody, that I don't care what you are going through. That if God be on your side, nobody can be against you. Instead of you wasting time thinking about the problem, you need to find how you'll be able to get God on your team. You need to find how you'll be able to get God on your side. And the only way you'll be able to get God on your team, the only way you'll be able to get God on your side, is by believing him. For he has said in his word, by faith, it is only through faith that we can please God. And they that believe in God, without faith, it is impossible to please God. And he that believes in him, I believe that he is and a rewarder. He is a rewarder of them that is yet to seek him. So the only way that we can get him on the demon is seeking him, giving him fear, and having faith in him, that in spite of the pain, in spite of the challenges, in spite of the troubles, in spite of the agonies that we are going through, he is able to make a way where there seems to be no way. Hallelujah. Amen. Elijah said, I hear the sound of the abundance of rain. Hallelujah. I hear the sound of the abundance of rain. I hear the sound of the abundance of rain. Hallelujah. I hear the sound of the abundance of rain. You know, sometimes it is frustrating when God is silent. Amen. Especially when you are a prophet or God speaks to you on a regular basis. Hallelujah. And a situation is confronting you, and you are praying about it, and nothing is happening. You know, then God just say that, oh, do this, and you begin to ask, oh God, where should I go? Where should I? How should I do it? Right? And God keeps silence, and God does not speak. Hallelujah. Sometimes you feel like getting out of it. Hallelujah. Sometimes you feel like quitting. Hallelujah. Sometimes you feel like, oh, I am not even worthy of carrying this vision. Sometimes you feel like it is not possible to make it. It is very frustrating when you know someone asks you to do something now, and he doesn't tell you how to do it, and you go back to the person and tell and ask her, how do you want me to do it, and he takes quiet and never respond to you. It is very frustrating sometimes, but I want you to know that whenever God is silent in life, God has a plan. Hallelujah. Whenever you feel like God has rejected you, like Jesus on the cross, he felt like God has rejected him, but God has a plan for mankind. He felt like God has taken his eyes off him, but God has a plan for mankind to save mankind. So he allowed him to go through that pain in order for us to be saved. Whenever you feel like God is silent, God has a plan and a purpose, and not until that plan is revealed, you might feel frustrated, you might get frustrated, you might get worried, you might get troubled, and you feel like, oh, I cannot make it. But I came to encourage you, somebody, that it doesn't matter how frustrated you are, it doesn't matter what you're going through, it doesn't matter how painful you are, the situation is, I want you to know that God has a plan. Let's trust in him, let's believe in him, and let's keep on going in the Lord, and trust in God, and believe God for a miracle. For a miracle is on this way. For I hear the sound of the abundance of prayer. I hear the sound of the abundance of prayer. I see God releasing jobs. I see God releasing miracles. I see God releasing healing. I see God telling what the doctors and the nurses are saying concerning you and your family. I see God releasing financial breakthroughs. I see the atmosphere being open. I don't care what the situation might be like. I don't care what you are going through. But I see God opening doors. I don't know how he's going to make it. I don't know how he's going to make this room through. But I know somewhere, somehow, he is going to make this room through. I don't know how he is going to get to the top. But I know somewhere, he is going to get you there. Only trust in him. Only keep on believing. And at the end of it, you know the beginning of the thing does not matter. But it is the end that does not find the means. The end that matters. I don't care what you are going through. I don't care the situation. I don't care what you are seeing. I don't care about the environment. But God has sent me to tell you. God has ordered me to tell you that he has released the abundance of blessings. Hallelujah. Amen. I'm ready to bring my message to a close. Hallelujah. But all that I'm saying is that I hear the sound of the abundance. Amen. I hear the sound of the abundance. God is about to do something great in our lives. Amen. And not only in our lives, in this church. Hallelujah. As I declare, so shall it be. In the mighty name of Jesus. God is about to do something that is extraordinary. Something that we ourselves, we have not perceived. Something that even me, I have not perceived. For this church, the Lord is about to do. And every year that we hear it will take. I know that people are waiting. They are putting their fingers across. And they are waiting that the church door will be closed. And the pastor will go back to Ghana. People are seeking that. And the pastor will go back to Ghana. People are waiting for that day. That will come. That the pastor will say, I am enough is enough. I'm no more to hear this church. They are waiting for that day to come. But I come to declare unto you, somebody, if you are waiting for that day to come, then you will be disappointed. Because God is about to do something new. Because God is about to do great and mighty things. Because something new is coming on His way. Because something great is coming on His way. Hallelujah. God is about to do something great.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
God is about to do something new.
Yes.
You know, from the beginning of the service, I must be honest with you. I was not really with you with the service. I even did not know that we have even taken our offerings. And I was like, then when they called me and they said, are we going to? I said in my spirit, have you taken the offerings and other stuff? But when I came and stood here and I saw that there is money in the bowl, I said, oh, they're taking the offering, hallelujah. But I came to declare unto you, somebody, it doesn't matter the struggles and the pain and the challenges that you are going through. The Lord is telling me to tell you right now that there is a sound of the abundance of rain coming in your life. It doesn't matter how dry the situation is. It doesn't matter how frustrated the situation might be, or how dead the situation might look like. It might look like a ghost and it is coming to threaten you. It might look like it is coming to take your life away. But I came to declare unto you that what you fear, that it is time to take away your life away. That's what you fear, that it is time to take that's what God has given to you away. That same thing, God is going to use it to bring honor and glory to you. The disciples thought that it is a ghost that is coming. It is coming to take your life away. And I believe in the ghost. They will be like, now Jesus is not here. The last time when the storms arose, Jesus spoke and the winds, and now that Jesus is not here, what are we going to do? And they begin to worry among themselves. What are we going to do? Now that Jesus is not here, and they begin to pray among themselves. What are we going to do? And they didn't know what to do. But they didn't know that when they are afraid of that when they were worrying about it was the Savior of the world that was coming to them. It was the mighty King, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. That when you think that it is going to kill this church, that when you think that it is going to kill your child, that when you think that it is going to kill your vision, that's what you think that it is going to kill you and it is going to take you out of your job situation. It is that same thing that the Lord will use to elevate your life. If you believe, say every amen and stand on your feet. Hallelujah.